are very blessed to have Bishop Kelly with us this evening. He has been a priest in the Dallas Diocese for nearly 34 years. Born in Iowa, the bishop grew up in Colorado and came to North Texas back in 1976 as a student at the University of Dallas and seminarian at Holy Trinity Seminary in Irving. Please join me in welcoming the Most Reverend John Gregory Kelly, Auxiliary Bishop of the Diocese of Dallas.
Get right back up here a little bit. Not quite as far. And one of the lines that I've heard Dr. Bariki say over and over again is, you know, keep in mind the twin goals of education is to get to college and get to heaven. And Catholic education enables us to keep both of those in the forefront. I was thinking about a story I read a long time ago about a sculptor who had a big block of marble. And a little boy was watching, and he was chipping away at this block of marble, and he said, "What you making?" And the sculptor said, "I'm carving an elephant." And the little boy said, "Well, how do you know there's an elephant in there?" He said, "Well, I just keep chipping away everything that doesn't look like an elephant, and I have an elephant at the end." We know that a human being is composed of a body, a mind, and a soul. And Catholic education enables us to call forth all that, call forth the whole person in a very explicit and orderly way. To pay attention to the body, so there's good food and there's physical education and there's sports, and the mind, so there's classes and all the homework that you have to do. But we're also able to talk very explicitly about the soul, about the human person as created in the image and likeness of God, body, mind, and soul. And that God is like the supreme sculptor who fashions each person in the womb of their mother. From the very first moment of their existence, God's work fashioning us and shaping us into the people He desires us to be. And our name is written on the palm of His hand. He knows each one of us individually. And we have a mission, we have a vocation. So for the young men and women who are recipients of this scholarship, the Lord is also preparing you for the work that He's going to call you to do, of handing on the gift that you have received to other people. So the gift that you are receiving now is for you, but not only for you, but it's also to share with somebody else someday. I'm the recipient of 18 years of Catholic education. 8 years at Sacred Heart School in Colorado Springs, Colorado. 4 years at St. Mary's High School. 6 years at the University of Dallas where I went to seminary. And I treasure that. But it also makes me want to share that richness with others. I'm so grateful that there's so many of you that also want to do that for these members of our families, these young members of our families. Who are members of our Catholic Church and now are participants in the life of our schools here in the Diocese of Dallas, who are body, mind, and spirit created in the image and likeness of God. Your name is written on God's hand, and you have a vocation, a mission in life. And Catholic education is to help you to know that and to say yes. And so every day that you go to Catholic school, you can say yes to God by doing the work that you're called to do, whether that's math or spelling or running laps, or going to Mass and saying prayers. You get to do all of that. And just say yes. And we are so grateful that you were here this evening. I also want to repeat the gratitude for so many of the donors who have made these 24 scholarships for these young men and women possible. I also found a little fact about Hugo, too, that our table is 10 today. This is 10 verses, so happy birthday to you.